Angela had a good time.
Oh, gorgeous. Here, I brought you some flowers, Mary. They only want a drop of water.
Oh, my, yes. You've got a lovely tan.
Yes. The sun did that.
That's the way it is, okay. Well, it's up to you. Sure. Look, I don't own you. I just wanna... I just want to know one thing. Are you with me or not? I don't care which it is. I just want to know. Okay? Okay?
Hello. Could I speak to Andrea, please?
Oh, no, not another one. Who is this?
Dennis Carter.
What do you want?
I just want to speak to her. Do you think I can or not?
I love you, Andrea. I've never really been able to tell you that before.
Hello, Dennis.
Hi.
Hello, Dennis.
Look, I forgot which you like best, dark or inferno, so I've got both. I thought it'd save time.
Oh, cheers. So you've been away a bit, then?
Yeah. Didn't you get my card?
Oh, yeah. Your holiday in the West Country.
Well, sort of business, really.
Oh.
Are you still seeing that other bloke, Clive?
Yeah,
sometimes. Well, listen, Andrea. A lot of people think I've just been on holiday with my mum.
Well, you have, haven't you?
Yeah. She was there some of the time. And, you know, we shared the petrol there and back, that sort of thing. But really, she was just there as a front.
A front for what?
OK. Now, you're going to find this hard to believe, Andrea, but somehow I've got myself involved with an international drugs ring. I need your help.
Why, is your mum busy?
No, she doesn't know anything about it. The thing is, it's quite a big operation. In fact, they want me to go back next weekend. And I was wondering whether you might, you know, like, possibly want to come as well.
What for?
Well, the problem is, they told me I've got to get a girlfriend just as cover. And, I mean, it could be you, or it could be someone else, or it could be you.
So what has this girlfriend got to do, then?
I don't know. They just said we probably have to stay in quite an expensive hotel, go to a few restaurants, a few flash nightclubs, and generally pretend to have a good time until the boat full of drugs arrives.
This hotel, Dennis, would we have to share the same room?
We might have to, yeah.
How much are they paying you for this high-risk sort of stuff?
Well, not much the first time, but, the next one could earn me $500,000.
$500,000?
I was hoping we might, go to Sri Lanka and maybe, you know, sort of live together.
Yeah, great. Well, I'd better be going, Dennis.
Well, can you come next weekend or not?
I can't really. I've got my mocks, you know.
What about the following weekend?
I don't know. You better be careful, Dennis. I'm telling you, you mess around with smack dealers, they chop you into little bits and send you in the post to your mum.
Don't worry about me, Andrea. As soon as I've offloaded the smack, I'm going to retire. It's only the stupid ones that peddle again. They're the ones that get caught.
OK, Dennis. See ya.
Evening.
Evening.
Constable Collins, Wandsworth Police. I'm formally arresting you on suspicion of trafficking dangerous drugs. And of course, it's my duty to warn you, you're not obliged to say anything. But if you do say anything, it may be written down and used in evidence against you. Finish the drink.
What?
I'm sorry about this, Andrea.
Why'd you go making up a story like that? You're pathetic, Dennis. It's the most stupid thing I've ever heard.
Look, he hasn't done anything. He's just making it all up. He does it all the time.
I don't see what you've done.
I mean, honestly, does he look like someone who's part of a drugs ring?
Oh, she's great, your girl.
I'm not his girl. He's a total arsehole. He's made it all up.
Oh, whoops, Frank, we've done it again. Isn't it funny how everyone we nicked's innocent?
Yeah.
Do you know, Frank and I haven't nicked a guilty man in 15 years.
God's sake, tell him, you stupid bastard!
I should keep quiet if I were you, love. You might get nicked for obstruction.
Look, she's got nothing to do with it.
Neither has he!
Oh, that's nice, isn't it? I do like a girl who stands by her man. Stand by your man.
La dee 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 dee.
You hurting me, didn't you? Come on. God's sake! He's not a drug dealer. He lives with his mum.
So do I.
Don't say any more, Andrew, until you see the solicitor.
Pissed, Wally.
Just trying to pick her up, wasn't he?
Lovely pair of bazookas, though.
You know, I can't believe how stupid some people are. Shooting his mouth off in a boozer.
Yeah.
Playing snooker tonight?
No, I'm taking Pat to CET.
I thought you'd seen that about five times.
Not with Dolby sound.
It's a funny thing about that film, you know. Everybody said, oh, you'll cry at the end, Frank. I said, don't be silly. I said that about Love Story, and I pissed myself. Tell you something, though. When that stupid green puppet said goodbye, I couldn't help it. There was tears rolling down my face. The lot. Wandsworth? Yes? Yes, thank you very much. Here. Commander Robertson, Criminal Intelligence, Scotland Yard. He's coming here in 10 minutes.
Okay, now.
Let's have a look.
Hello, Dennis. You all right? Sorry it's not the Ritz, but, you know.
Got a cup of tea? Cigarette?
No, thanks.
Anything you want, Dennis, just let us know.
What's that for?
Don't worry. It's for the scrapbook, not for the records. Get lower.
All right, Dennis.
I don't smoke.
Lovely. Yeah, come on. We better get going.
Okay, Dennis.
Scotland Yard.
Constable Collins.
Constable Frank, sir.
We're the arresting officers.
Better report.
This is a big breakthrough, sir.
Yeah, you had a feeling, didn't you, George? He's definitely got a nose for it, sir.
Who spoke to him?
Well, we both did, but only in the car.
Just to be sociable.
What's your impression? Well, in my opinion, sir, he's either very, very stupid or very, very clever.
How did you
definitely mentioned there was a drop planned for this weekend.
Yes, sir.
In the West Country. You're sure about that?
Most definitely, sir.
Who else knows he's here?
Not just the two of us.
Make sure it stays that way. It's very crucial. Do you understand?
Of course, sir.
Where'd you get that suntan, Dennis?
On holiday.
Where?
I'm not saying anything until I've seen the solicitor.
Officer, do you have a first aid box in this station?
Well, of course, sir.
Good, have this man beaten up.
No! Look, don't hit me, I'll tell you!
I'll tell you! I was in Oak Cove in Devon with my mum!
Thank you very much. Carter was there with his mum, sir.
Very clever.
What is?
The fact they use a young man with no police record and place him right here on the spot with his mum. It's brilliant.
What, you don't think he's one of the ringleaders?
Dennis Carter is just a pawn.
Oh, a prawn.
Sorry about all this, Dennis. I was at my daughter's birthday party. She's 18.
Oh.
Nice kids. How old are you?
25.
Awful place, this, isn't it? What a stench. Can you imagine being locked up in a place like this for the rest of your life, 23 hours a day, with some evil pervert? Can you unhook this for me? Do you know the meaning of the term Queen's evidence?
Yeah. It's somebody who informs on their friends in return for money and freedom.
Yes.
You mean like a supergrass?
Dennis, you're still very young. You've got a clean record.
Yeah, I know.
There's still time for you to make a fresh start. I'm leaving this job next month to become a priest. I've spent two very depressing years on Operation Bolthead without getting a single lead. Before I take my vows, Dennis, I'll do anything to get those bastards nicked. What I'm saying is, if you help me to catch that drugs ring, I'll make a deal with you.
Hey?
A new life abroad, guaranteed income, tax-free. The world's yours, Dennis. Beach bar in the Caribbean, a flat in Rio.
What about Sri Lanka?
Why not?
Can I take Andrea?
I've come to see Commander Robertson.
Hello, Harvey. Heard the news?
What?
Operation Bolthead. We've cracked it. Me and George nicked a courier.
Where is he?
There.
Hi.
What do you think, Harvey?
He's not a drug smuggler.
I know. Brilliant, isn't it?
Shows how cunning they are, the evil bastards. Now, this is what I want you to do, Harvey. Carter says they're planning a drop here, possibly this weekend, and he is meant to be there to meet the boat, and that is exactly what I want him to do. So I'm sending you and another police officer along with him.
Who?
Nice girl, policewoman Leslie Reynolds. Do you know her? It's all a bit of a rush, I'm afraid. Reynolds is in the canteen at the moment.
Some crisps.
Right, Dennis. I've decided to send you to Hope Cove with your girlfriend as planned.
Oh, thank you very much.
It seems to me very important that you are there this weekend when the boat arrives.
Well, they did say that it might take a bit longer. You know what the weather's like in the Bay of Biscay.
How much longer? Days? Weeks?
Fortnight?
I'd like you to meet these two police undercover officers, Dennis. This is Harvey Duncan, who will be acting as your minder, and policewoman Leslie Reynolds, who will be going as your girlfriend.
That's not my girlfriend.
She is now.
Well, what about Andrea? Why isn't she coming?
For obvious reasons, Leslie is taking her place.
Oh. How'd you do?
What kind of car would you use on a job like this?
Car? Something quite big and flashy, I was thinking.
What, like a Jag?
Yeah, that's it. With a stereo.
Jag. Now, where will you be staying?
Hotel?
Which hotel?
Probably the big one on the cliff, the Royal. It's great. It's got everything. Balconies, colour TVs, private bathrooms.
Andrea, quite intimate. So to make this look convincing, you and Officer Reynolds would have to share the same room.
We would have to, yeah.
Double or twin beds?
Double?
Who pays for everything?
Well, you do, don't you?
I mean, who physically pays the hotel?
Oh, I see, yeah. I do.
In cash?
Yeah, in cash. I always pay in cash.
Right. Well, I think I'm going to need about £3,000. Sign for this, Harvey, will you?
Thanks very much. Reception once you leave London, isn't it? Can't seem to find Radio 1 on this thing. Well, that's Radio 2, isn't it? Which do you like, 1 or 2?
I don't mind.
I think I like Radio 1 better. It's usually on 285.
Just watch the road.
Oh, that's it? Oh, great, reggae. I love reggae. No woman, no cry. Imagine, dying of cancer at 36. Poor bloke.
How old are you?
I'm 28.
Had a checkup?
Where are you going?
A303. It's the pretty route.
Why?
I always go this way. If I go on the motorway, I usually nod off and then crash.
Go the pretty route.
You can usually pick up Radio Basingstoke around here. Nah. This radio's crap.
What are you doing?
Just getting some tapes.
And I'll have that auto number ones.
It's gone.
Have you seen Thriller?
Yeah.
That's the one he wore in the video.
Really?
Goes really nice with the polo neck, you know.
Yeah. Oh, hi, Harv. What do you think? They got it in blue and white as well.
I don't know. Just gonna have a look in the light.
I thought I might need it down there, you know. It gets a bit nippy in the evenings.
I think we ought to get to know each other a bit better, don't you?
Yeah, that's a good idea. I was born in Kent. Where were you born?
I was born in Kent too.
That's interesting. It's a great county. Where were you born, Harv?
Andover.
That's a funny place, isn't it? Tell me, what do you think about scuba diving? Apparently, it's quite a fast-growing sport.
You can't swim.
Oh, I love swimming. I was in the school team. It was the only thing I was really any good at.
Yeah, I thought you had a swimmer's build. First thing I noticed about you.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not really muscly. I've just got big lungs. You got big lungs.
No, I'm all muscle.
Should we have a tape on there?
Drunk.
Blind.
Deaf.
Leopard.
Spots.
Beauty.
Famous.
Supergrass.
Dead.
Torso.
Police.
Driving license.
Don't have one.
What?
I haven't got one.
Shit.
Pants!
Shut up, Dennis. Tell him we're on holiday.
Hi, we're going on holiday.
Oh, yeah? Where's that, then? France?
No, no, West Country. You know, cream tea, surfboarding, all that.
No, you see, the reason I said France is because I thought you might be getting in some practice, you know, for driving on the wrong side of the road. Name?
Dennis Carter.
Dennis Carter. I'm going to show you something, Dennis. What's that, Dennis?
White line.
White line?
A white line, yes. Now, in France, going that way, they would drive on this side of the road, the right side. But in Angleterre, Monsieur Dennis, we still drive on the...
left.
Left!
The left! Correct! But you were driving on this side of the road when you should have been driving on this side of the road. Comprenez-vous, Monsieur Dennis?
You must be the funniest copper in the world.
What did you say?
He says he's very sorry, officer, and he'll never do it again.
Documents?
In the post.
In the post.
Can't you speak for yourself?
Yes.
Yes.
I don't like you. Now, I could have been difficult with you, Dennis. But instead, I'm going to be unreasonably difficult. Get out the car.
Hello.
Could I have a look at that, please, sir?
You're looking at it.
Well, do you think I could have a quick word with you? What are you up to?
It's confidential.
I see. It's just that, is it something undercover? You know, a secret operation or something?
Oh, I can't tell you.
It's just that, you know, if you told me which case it was, see, the thing is, I know this area pretty well, and I could probably help you out, you know.
No, we're okay, thanks.
Is it drugs?
It's none of your business.
Ah, how'd you get into plain clothes? See, I'd love to work undercover. I've applied 3 times, but they don't seem to want me, you know. But the thing is that I feel somehow that I'd make a really good detective, you know.
I'm sorry, it's not my problem.
Now, maybe I could just come with you, you know, sort of hang around, you know, because then I'd be mixing with people, you know, who could maybe help me. I mean, come on, I mean, somebody must have helped you when you first started out, didn't they?
No, sorry.
I see. Well, thanks for all your help. Sorry if I held you up. Must be really irritating when you're doing an important undercover operation to be held up. But just doing my job, sir. Yes, right. It's been nice meeting you. Thank you very much.
Car keys.
Nice of him, isn't it? Do you think he's going to do that all the way to Hope Cove?
Take the next left, Dennis.
What for? Only leads to a village.
Turn left.
Okay.
Next right. Fuck off. Okay, Dennis, I'll drive now.
Okay.
We'll be right back. half.
Well done, Harvey.
Yeah, nice bit of driving, Harvey.
Whoops.
It says no stopping on this road, Harvey.
Yeah, corner of Devil's Leap. You better send an accident unit and also an ambulance. Over.
Roger, repeat 51, come on.
Right. Won't keep you long, mate. Just been a little accident. I suggest you switch your engine off. Oh, it's a real black spot, this. Number of times I've seen this happen. I've seen some horrible accidents along here. You see, what happens is they come hammering along this straight, not realising that this is, in fact, a very sharp corner. And, of course, what happens is... Wham! Oh!
We booked a couple of rooms.
What was the name, please, sir?
Sorry?
Name, please.
Dennis.
Carter.
Oh, yes, a single and a double. We require £50 deposit. Is that OK, sir?
Yeah, yeah. No worries.
Would you like breakfast in bed?
Not half. Is that all right with you, love?
That's perfect.
Don't mention it. It's nice here, isn't it? It's a lovely view. Oh, we're going to unpack first?
Well, I am.
Right, well, I will too, then. Do you want to use the big drawer or the little ones?
I don't mind.
I like the little ones. Then I can keep my socks and knickers in one drawer and my polo necks in the other.
Fine.
So this is it, is it? This is where it's all going to happen. This is where a boat's going to arrive from out there. More up here with a massive shipment of drugs.
And we're going to swoop down and nick them.
Subject to natural disasters, yeah.
All right, so here with Andrea.
You've checked in, you're poised for action. What next?
Well, nice walk, spot of sunbathing, maybe a swim. Do you fancy a swim?
We'll do the nice walk.
Yeah.
You ever taken drugs, Dennis?
Yeah, I've taken heroin a couple of times. It didn't do anything for me.
So what's the amount you're expecting on the next drop?
Oh, a lorry load at least.
Must be quite a big boat then.
Yeah. Or a small lorry.
Waiter. Another one of these, please.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Cigar?
Thank you.
No, I love travelling, don't you? I mean, it's a big world, isn't it? And I always think, you know, life's very short. You get married, you have kids, you get old, and then you die. It's a bit of a gamble, really, isn't it? You've got to be lucky. But then again, I don't think they'll catch up with me in Sri Lanka.
Why not?
Because I'll grow a moustache. I could grow a beard, I could, but I always think people with beards have got something to hide, you know. You ever grown a beard, Harvey?
No.
No, nor have I. Oh, yeah, that's lovely. Yeah, thank you. How's it been with you this season, then? Busy?
Not bad, a bit varied, you know.
Yeah, I can imagine, yeah.
And the hotel trade's like that. It's up and down all the time. You get a slack period, then you get a busy period.
Yeah. Yes, you do, don't you?
Definitely. I'm constantly surprised. Sometimes this place is full of people, then there's no one.
It varies, then?
All the time.
Well, it's certainly a very nice hotel you've got here.
Thank you. Well, it's a pleasure to have you. I hope you have a very pleasant holiday.
Well, it's very nice of you to say so. Thank you very much. Nice guy.
Doesn't this sea air make you tired? Another mint, Harvey?
No, thank you.
I think it's time for bed.
Yeah, I think that as well.
You turning in, Harvey?
Been a while.
Yeah. Well, night, Harvey.
Can I use the
Which side of the bed do you want to sleep on?
The middle. Which side do you want?
I don't care. I'll sleep on the left if you like.
Okay.
So I'm sure that a lot of people like me are looking forward to seeing you again in the autumn with another series of the very naughty boys. But meanwhile, let's get back to some music. Here's Ted Willis Orchestra, and Don't Stop Doing That Thing to Me.
Good night, then.
Dennis, I'm not going to have sex with you if that's what you're thinking.
Oh, God, no. That'd be so stupid, wouldn't it?
Bed and breakfast.
It is very late, isn't it?
11:15.
That's right.
It's raining.
Well, I have one left, but it is...
I'll take it.
Okay, come in. Here we are. The bed, the basin, the chair, the wardrobe. Breakfast at 8. All right, good night.
Champagne, Harvey?
He doesn't drink.
Leslie? Sorry. Andrea?
Dennis?
Yeah?
This lorry, where is it going to pick up the shipment?
On this beach here, I should think. On the other hand, there could be a secret tunnel they could use.
Where?
Well, I don't know, but I was told there is one round here that leads to a farm. Apparently, it's an old secret wartime tunnel that was used by submarine crews who didn't want to be seen getting in and out of their submarines. What do you reckon? Shall we go and have a look for it?
I'll come with you, Dennis.
He's leaving chalk marks around the town. Yes. Yes, and now he's got us looking for a submarine nest. No, it's a waste of time, sir. Well, he's spending money like water.
But don't be a wet blanket, Harvey. Stick it out for a few more days. You never know. God willing, something might turn up.
That again, I shall take you out to sea and drown you.
Bastard spring from, son.
How did I know?
Stop blabbering, will you?
Why, what did he say to you?
He said he was going to drown me.
Yes, 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 apart from that.
Did he ask you anything about us?
No, he just took my spade.
Will you shut up talking about your spade? I paid for it.
Why are you being so horrible to us? We're only acting like normal children.
Listen, you're being paid to do as you're told and not go around making big scenes on the beach.
Well, what are we being paid for? Our agent said we're coming here to model a new range of kiddies' clothes.
So?
Well, so far, we've seen no kiddies' clothes and no camera.
Yeah, well, I'm waiting for the light, aren't I? Right, go on, get to bed.
I'm hungry.
Well, here's some chocolates. Now get to bed.
Chocolate's bad for your teeth.
Yeah, so's a smack in the mouth. Now get in there.
Good here, isn't it? I love this place. Sea air, friendly atmosphere. I like coming here even when I'm not smuggling drugs.
Keep your voice down.
Hey, look! Jim.
Oh, hello, Dennis.
How's the boat?
Oh, it's good. It's very good. What are you doing here, then?
Ah, this and that.
Oh, yeah. I can see that.
So, what have you been doing, then?
Oh, you know me, doing the usual, smuggling heroin.
What?
Yeah, a couple of tons worth. I sold most of it to the kids down by the primary school.
Really?
Yeah. I tell you what, you want to try some? I've got a sack left.
No, it's okay. We're, going for a drink.
You had half a wally sometimes. Ian, half a wally, innit, eh? I tell you what, there's a disco tonight. You want to come?
Eh? In the wilds of Borneo,
vineyards of Bordeaux, Eskimo, Arapaho.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the 27th of this month is Young Farmers Dinner and Disco at Bampton Village Hall. So I expect to see you all there with your dancing shoes. All right now. Right, now this is especially for Mary on her birthday. So here it is, Mary.
I thought you might be here.
Oh, you did you?
Audrey, innit?
Andrea.
Oh, yeah, but Dennis was telling me all about you.
Wasn't he?
Here we go.
Cheers,
Dennis. There you go, half. Your tomato juice with all the trimmings.
Who's he?
Oh, that's Jim. He's a fisherman.
Listen, I'd really like to dance with you.
OK. Hold this, Ollie.
Dennis. I think you're really beautiful, Audrey.
It's Andrea, thank you.
Right. Is he one of them?
No, he's a good bloke, Jim. I should think he's probably too kind to be a member of an international drugs ring.
Sure.
Right now, has it got a red Cortina blocking the road out there? Registration number is...
Andre, listen, I've got to make love with you tonight. Yeah, Dennis, want to score some dope, eh?
How much?
Well, it's 20 quid a quarter. Good stuff, though, we're rocking.
Let me 20 quid, Dennis.
Yeah, of course. Fuck me, then. That's quite a word you got there, son. Want to buy a boat, eh?
Come on, then, girls, all pick yourself a bite. Here we go, then.
Any idea where he got this?
No idea.
Who wants to dance? Dennis?
Yeah. Great.
Hey, baby. You go your way.
You want to dance?
And I'll go mine.
Go on.
Us one of them.
But in the meantime...
They're all about 16.
When we're together, touching each other, and our bodies do what we feel.
It's time for some real dancing music. So I want you all to give a big warm welcome now, please, for Dave Pearce.
Had a good group, did you, Dennis?
Should have been dancing, Harvey. It was fun.
Well, I did I? What's happened to our drinks? Oh, well, I'll get some more. Another tomato juice, half? How come you don't drink? You're Muslim or something?
No, I'm a Buddhist monk.
Oh.
twat.
I think you're cracking up.
Shut up. You're enjoying all this, aren't you?
What am I supposed to act like a misery?
Oh, piss off.
Grab hold of yourself, Harvey, before you blow everything.
What?
I was just thinking then how trusting you are. I mean, how do you know I won't run away in the middle of the night?
Because I'll be sleeping with your bollocks in my hand.
Right. Well, all right, I think it's time to start the raffle for the sherry now, isn't it? Where's Mrs. Goodchild? Mrs. Goodchild, bring that over here, my dear. That's right. Now, come on. Put your numbers out. Now, who's going to win this lovely £5 bottle of VP wine, then? Well, I'll just dig round here a minute.
I'm sorry you and Harvey aren't getting on too well, Leslie.
It's okay, Dennis.
Do you think it was something I said? Maybe I should go and apologise.
I hope you're right. You're just drunk, that's all.
Do you think he'll be all right on his own?
Yes, Dennis. Can you turn my light out, Dennis?
Okay. Harvey.
Get up, Dennis. We're going for a walk.
What, before breakfast?
Now.
What you're telling us now, Dennis, is that a submarine is going to signal you with three dots and two dashes.
Yeah. The letter D. D for Dennis.
And you're waiting here right on this beach?
Yeah. Just over there.
I've had enough of this. That little bastard calls me Harv one more time.
Harv?
That's it.
Don't, Harvey.
This is the best vantage point about here.
Now listen to me, you little moron. I don't want to hear any more shit about submarines or secret tunnels. Is that clear?
Yes, Harvey.
I just want some straight answers from you, Dennis. All I want is a name. The name of the person who first contacted you.
It was a man.
What man?
A Mexican. I don't know his name.
A Mexican. A Mexican walks up to you in the street, Dennis, and says, hello, do you want to get yourself involved in a drugs ring? Very hard to turn down, I think, wasn't it, Dennis?
What do you look like?
Dark, sort of loose-fitting clothes, and he had a patch over one eye.
No parrot?
No. But he had a scar down one side of his face.
Oh, he had the scar then, did he?
Where'd you meet him?
I met him here.
What, just here?
On the beach.
Where on the beach? Show me, Dennis. Show me the spot, the exact fucking spot.
Well, it was, it was just over here. Ah!
I don't know what to say.
Dear God, thank you for sending me an underground chamber full of incriminating evidence. I know, God, that all events are preordained. But please help me to catch these evil men and bring them to the Old Bailey, that they may be sent down forever and ever. Amen. Harvey, wonderful news. We can thank God for this.
Sure. Oh, Troy's already here. Sorry, have I read what?
The Power and the Glory by Graham Greene. It's a wonderful book. No, it's really about the gap between one's conscience and one's religious beliefs.
Well, I'll see if I can get a copy. Is it in paperback?
Find a chamber under the beach containing outboard motors, wet suits and a transmitter.
Imagine. Nice to tell, isn't it? Why can't I stay here?
You know why. Dennis!
Coming!
There was no hot water this morning. The pilot had gone out. It's the same every operation, isn't it? I end up sleeping in the Kazi, and all because Robinson thinks I'm too fat to ponce around pretending to be a drug dealer.
He's convinced that all drug pushers are skinny.
Stupid fucker.
This is Troy.
Wrestling, darts,
Detective Sergeant Troy.
How'd you do?
Rain forecast. Sunny periods.
So, you're the super squealer.
I'm Dennis. Dennis the Menace.
Come here. Closer. Accommodation good enough for you, is it?
Yeah, it's fine.
Food all right?
That's good too.
Now, you served me up an egg this morning. It wasn't cooked. Must imagine I'll eat anything just because I'm fat.
I don't think you're fat. I think you're just very well built.
Do you do a lot of running, Squealer?
Yeah, quite a bit.
Good.
Who's that twat wandering about?
How should I know?
Maybe it's Brabham. He should be here by now, shouldn't he?
Oh, calm down, will you? He'll contact us when he's ready.
Oh, we should get his skates on. I mean, all this hanging about's making me feel a bit wiggy.
And you should count yourself lucky, pal. You're not the one who has to wear a bra and suspenders. It's really uncomfortable. You should try it.
You got the legs for it, didn't you?
But what's so special about my legs? They're just longer than yours, that's all.
Don't tease me like that, Gunter.
Well, don't look, then.
I can't help it. I love suspenders, even on you.
Well, don't start trying to get randy again, pal. I don't know what's got into you, Wong. It never used to be like this.
Like what?
This queer game you keep playing. I can't sleep properly at night now in case you try something on.
Oh, do leave it out, Gunter.
No, I want to have this out. You've never been like this before on any of our previous drug runs.
Yeah, well, you've never worn silk stockings before, have you?
told Andrea I was a drug smuggler. She didn't fancy me because she thought I was too law-abiding. It was just a story to impress her. I just wanted her to get down here for the weekend. Next thing I know, I'm driving a fast car with $3,000 in my pocket. It all became a bit of a laugh, really.
Well, it's certainly cracking me up, Dennis.
It's the truth, I promise.
You are a fucking moron. And so's Robertson. I told you he was clinically insane.
What about Jim?
Oh, little squealer here stuck a knife in his neck, didn't you?
That'd be stupid.
Pardon?
How did you meet him?
He lent me his boat.
What for?
To drop some money out at sea.
What money?
I wrapped up some money in a polythene bag. It was to impress Andrew that I was getting paid off.
How much?
£30.
£30? That is impressive.
It was all I had.
Is it still there?
I think so.
Well, let's hope for your sake it is.
That's it! I knew it'd be there!
Did you? Hey? Well, I don't care what you say. I just want to beat you to a pulp. Hey? And shoot your heart. Accidentally give out? Well, there isn't a judge in the country would blame me. So, tell me, Squealer, when is this boat coming?
Look, I know this sounds unconvincing.
Tell us, Dennis.
There isn't a boat!
When's it coming, Squealer?
What's it look like?
Colour!
White!
Oh. White boat, is it? When's it arriving, this white boat? Eh, Squealer?
Seven!
Should have done that 8 weeks ago. Bloody wet liberals.
Money's gone.
What?
I said the money's gone! What have you done with it?
I haven't touched it.
Yeah, well, you were the last one to check it.
Well, it was there yesterday.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's funny, isn't it? Because it ain't there today.
Are you implying something, pal?
Yes. One of us two is a lying motherfucker, and it ain't me.
Well, it's no me neither.
Oh, that's really funny, isn't it, eh? Someone sees a squeezy bottle out in the ocean and thinks, hello, there's £500,000 tied to it. A bit bloody unlikely, wouldn't you say?
Yes, very unlikely.
Stop copying me all the time.
Oh, you're so goddamn original, are you, you guilt-ridden gay boy?
I am not gay!
All this blue-eyed outrage. Oh, where's the money gone? In fact, you're such a good actor, you should be in films.
Oh, yeah? You think so?
Yeah, yeah, but you better stick to profile shots, because you're only going to have half a face left.
Oh, yeah? Well, let me see you do it, you broken-down old drag queen. Do you know what? I was going to kill you even if you hadn't taken the money.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, that's exactly what I was going to. I was going to kill you too.
Yeah, but do you know why I was going to kill you?
No, why?
Because you overreact.
Thanks, Harvey.
I don't understand you, Dennis. There's one question I want to ask you.
Oh, look, I made it all up, Harvey.
That's not the question.
Did you make love with Leslie?
Yes. Are you in love with Leslie? Oh, dear. Does she love you?
I don't know.
Well, why don't you ask her?
Ask her what? Is it private or something?
No. We're just having a truth game, that's all.
No, we're not.
Truth game, yes. I suppose truth game. It'd be nice to find out what's going on around here. Who's got the next question?
Harvey.
Right, did you lie about the money, Dennis?
No, I didn't. OK, it's my turn. Leslie, did you know that Harvey was madly in love with you?
What?
Did you know...
It's none of your business.
It's a truth game. You said you wanted to play.
All right, yes, I did.
Right, it's your turn.
If you're in love with me, Harvey, why did you leave?
Because you slept with Sergeant Peacock.
Your turn, Harvey.
Why'd you do that?
Because I was tired of you trying to suffocate me the whole time.
What do you mean?
You just wanted me to mother you, Harvey.
Hang on. It's my turn, Leslie. Right, now, that first morning when we came to the hotel and you said you weren't going to have sex with me, did you want to, really?
No.
Oh, I did. Your turn.
Was I the first woman you ever slept with?
Yes, Harvey?
Would you like to play a duet with me, Mr. Troy?
Great, isn't it?
Okay, I've got a good one. Leslie, who's got the biggest knob? Me or Harvey?
You have.
I don't believe it. Come on, let's see it.
Fuck off! I'm not getting it out. No, it's your turn.
All right, Leslie. When we used to make love, did you ever fake your orgasms?
Yes.
Yeah, I got another one. When you go to the toilet and you wipe your bum, do you look at the paper afterwards?
Leslie's go.
When you used to go down on me, Harvey, did you do it because you wanted to, or were you just being polite?
I did it to make you happy.
Okay. Someone guess how many times I masturbate a day.
Did you cry when you left me? Harvey's room tonight, Dennis.
The key.
Your hands behind your feet.
What are you going to do to me?
You're going to die, Brabham. That's what.
Brabham, my name's not Brabham.
Oh, well, you're sitting here with our money and you're telling us you're not Brabham.
Well, who are you then?
I'm a police officer. That's my idea on that chest there.
Oh, yeah. Harvey Duncan. That's you, is it?
That's right. And I've been expecting you punks to turn up for quite some time.
So how did you get onto us then, Harvey?
A Supergrass.
What does grass tell you then?
There's a shipment arriving in Hope Cove.
When?
Tomorrow.
Shit! What do you now?
I'm quite happy to kill a policeman.
Okay then, do it. I don't care. You'll be doing me a favour. I'm gonna die of cancer in 6 months anyway.
But that's all right then, isn't it? Dennis?
What's happened?
It's that weird family in the beach house.
Sorry about all this, Harvey.
You cut up the wrong boat.
Yeah, well, it's done now, isn't it?
Harvey?
What?
Nothing.